Technoelite. I am Dipmala Vakode. In the last session, we have learned different types of arrays in PHP. Also, we have taken a look at the array functions in PHP. In this session, I am going to show you how to work with date and time function in PHP. So, let's get started with subscribing the channel and hit the bell so you don't miss anything. So, let's open the Visual Studio Code and don't forget to start XAMPP server. I am going to create a new file here and call it as datetime.php. PHP date function is an inbuilt function that simplifies working with date data type. The PHP date function is used to format a date or time into a human readable format. It can be used to display the date of the last updated data in a database. PHP date function will return the current date time of the server. So let's have a look at the syntax first. Let's have a PHP tag here. Here we have a date function having a format parameter separated by a comma. Next we have a timestamp parameter. Here format parameter specifies the format of the date and time. And timestamp parameter specifies a timestamp. A timestamp is a sequence of characters denoting the date and time at which a certain event occurred. The format is required where timestamp is optional. If no timestamp has been provided, PHP will get the current date time on the server. So let's have an example to format today's date in a different way. So let's have echo today is. Let's have a dot here and now I'm going to have a date function and now let's specify the format of the date y/m/d, put a dot here and now let's have a break tag here end with the semicolon. Here y represents a year, m represents a month and d represents the day of the month. You can also insert slash dot or dash, that is minus symbol, between the characters to add additional formatting. Save this and let's have a look at the output. Type here localhost colon 8080 slash tutorial and now change the file name datetime.php and it will print the current date on the browser in year, month and date format. And now let's see what happens if I use the capital letters for year, month and date. Simply copy this. And now I'm going to change the letters in capital. Save this and let's have a look at the output. Reload the page. Here capital Y represents the year in 4 digits, where Y in small letter represents the year in 2 digits and capital letter M represents the 3 letter of month and capital D represents the first 3 letters of the day of the week. And now let's see what is timestamp. The computer stores date and time in a format called Unix timestamp, which measures time as a number of seconds. Let's define a time function here. Let's have echo time function, put a dot here and now let's have a break tag here. Save this and refresh the browser. This is an impractical format for human to read. PHP converts a timestamp to a format that is readable to human. Let me show you. Let's have echo. The time is. And now put a dot here and let's have a date function. And now let's pass the argument h:i:sa, put a dot here. And now let's have a break tag here. Here h represents 12-hour format of an hour with leading zeros. I represents the minutes with leading zero. And s represents seconds, where a represents antimeridian and postmeridian. Save this and let's have a look at the output. Reload the page. And it will display the time. If the time is not correct, it's probably because your server is set up for a different time zone. You can set the time zone according to your specific location. So let's have a look at how to get the list of supported time zone. I'm going to declare a variable, say time zone equals to date time zone. And then let's have a colon list identifiers followed by a parenthesis end with the semicolon. The list identifier method returns a list of constants that are assigned to a variable $timezone. And now let's have a for each keyword followed by a parenthesis. Now let's have a variable timezone as $key equals to and greater than symbol $list opening and closing curly bracket. And now let's echo $list, put a dot here, and let's have a break tag here, and it will print the list of the time zone. Save this and refresh the browser, and here we have a list of time zone. So you can use this to set your location. And now let's see how we can set the time zone. For example, I'm going to copy this after the closing curly bracket. We have a date default time zone set function. To set the default time zone, and inside the bracket, let's have a time zone end with the semicolon. And now let's echo the time is put a dot here. And now let's have a date function. And now let's pass the argument h:i:sa end with the semicolon. Save this and let's have a look at the output. Reload the page and it will display the time at your location. Well, that's all for today's session. In the next session, we will see some more interesting things in PHP. To learn more, subscribe the channel and hit the bell to receive the notification. If you enjoy the video, hit the like and comment below. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.